So research tasks for this project are formulated as follows. Investigation of structures and electronic properties of various tetraphosphor metalloporphyrins and factors which could affect their structural and electronic properties. Investigation of optical and photophysical properties of these tetraphosphor metalloporphyrins. Study of interactions and complex formations with small molecules, for instance, O2, N2, NO, CO, with ions and with various small organic molecules. Study of activation of these small molecules and potential catalytic activity of tetraphosphor metalloporphyrins. Investigation of interactions of tetraphosphor metalloporphyrins and their derivatives with various fullerenes and nanoparticles, including cadmium selenide or cadmium telluride species. And finally, theoretical design of two-dimensional and three-dimensional nanoclusters of tetraphosphor metalloporphyrins. Estimated time demands are 4 semesters, maybe more. Okay, let's proceed to the second research project, complexes between polyoxymetallates and metalloporphyrins with potential catalytic applications. So why is it interesting? Complexes between porphyrins and polyoxymetallates could be of two types, made by coordinative interactions and electrostatic interactions. They are potentially photocatalytically active. So here are examples of these compounds with covalent bond between substituted porphyrin and polyoxymetallate. And another one, the complex made by electrostatic interaction between this kind of polyoxymetallate and these kinds of substituted metalloporphyrins. So some more words about why these compounds are interesting for us. Here is the list of important features and advantages of polyoxymetallates. They are stable towards oxidation and hydrolysis, and they are able to undergo photoexcitation and to exhibit multiple redox processes. For this, they are called electron reservoirs. Photoexcited polyoxymetallates have high oxidizing ability, which could lead to degradation of a variety of organic pollutants. Polyoxymetallates have enormous potential for structural variation and tuning of their properties. And most of the elements in the periodic table can be incorporated in polyoxymetallates. Polyoxymetallates absorb only UV light, but their combination with metalloporphyrins makes them able to utilize the visible light. So this table summarizes some types of polyoxymetallates which potentially could be used in this, considered in this research. Here are some structures of examples of structures of polyoxymetallates. And this diagram shows how polyoxymetallates could be tuned. The central heteroatom could be substituted by different elements. Framework atoms could be also different. Some groups could be bound to frameworks through oxygens. These metals could be also picked up could be picked up different. Different groups could be coordinated to these transition metals, and finally, different bridges could bind these transition metals. Also, another way to tune properties of polyoxymetallates is just to remove this unit to create so-called lacunary polyoxymetallate, which can coordinate to any other species. And this picture is just a brief reminder how structures and therefore properties of porphyrins could be tuned. So as we can see, the potential for tuning structures and properties of complexes between polyoxymetallates and metalloporphyrins is really immense. Here are just some more motivation, some more recent pieces of motivation, so to say, the report on charge transfer for the induced electron transfer between polyoxymetallate and non-planar TIN4 porphyrin. Another report on catalytic activity, synthesis and characterization of this kind of complexes between small polyoxymetallates and metalloporphyrins or free porphyrins. And one more report on theoretical exploration of nonlinear optical properties of this kind of complexes between substituted zinc porphyrins and this kind of Kagan polyoxymetallates. Research tasks for this project are formulated as follows. Systematic investigation of complexes which are formed by covalent electrostatic and coordination interactions between polyoxymetallates and metalloporphyrins, and also investigation of factors which could influence structures, stabilities, and catalytic properties of these complexes. The ultimate goal is formulated as a formulation of theoretical predictions for future synthesis and characterization of complexes between porphyrins and Kagan or Dawson types of polyoxymetallates. Time demands are estimated again about four semesters, but potentially longer. And now to the final, to the third project, which is devoted to novel sandwich compounds made by transition metal complexes. So first, again, a few words of motivation. What are sandwich compounds and why are they interesting? So these are examples of sandwich complexes made by transition metals and organic molecules, so-called metallocenes. So potentially useful properties of these sandwich compounds. They are easily reduced and oxidized. They could be easily derivatized. They possess electron conductivity. And of course, they should have some more properties which are still to be discovered. So a few lines of the history for the sandwich compounds studies. Various one-dimensional sandwich molecular wires have been extensively studied. Initial focus was on clusters made by transition metals and benzene or cyclopentadiene. Significant attention has been given to complexes based on cyclooctatetraene and lanthanoids and transition metal complexes. Main focus in this study was on stability, charge transfer, electronic structure, and magnetic properties. Several mixed sandwich clusters between, as we can see, benzene, transition metals, and fullerenes have been theoretically investigated as well. And recently, relatively recently, the first linear triple-decked sandwich complex of an F element was successfully synthesized. So as we can see, quite a lot has been done, but still the picture is quite fragmentary, I would say. So what specifically is interesting for us in this project, within the framework of this project? Design of one-dimensional complexes or wires with more than one metal atom between two ligands, organic or inorganic. Design of complexes with metal clusters containing both organic and non-organic ligands, inorganic ligands. What new properties these sandwich complexes with metal clusters could have? And to study possibilities to design two or three-dimensional complexes with these metal clusters and their potential applications. So these are examples of clusters which served as motivation for this project. As we can see, palladium-4 cluster sandwiched by two organic ligands, and I should say that actually much larger sheets of planes of palladium palladium clusters were sandwiched between organic ligands. And also report on this relatively small organic, transition metal clusters sandwiched by various organic and inorganic ligands. So multiple metal centers in one unit, in a single molecular unit, lead to so-called cooperative effects between them, which could lead to potential applications of these sandwich compounds in molecular electronics, catalysis, magnetic and optical materials, polymers, medicine, nanodevices, and so on. And research tasks for this project, within this project are formulated as follows. Theoretical design of sandwich complexes containing transition metal clusters and various ligands. To answer the question first, what would be the largest number of transition metal atoms at which the sandwich compound is still stable? To study complexes with containing both same and different transition metals in the same cluster, multiple Decker systems containing several layers of transition metals and ligands. The principal goal is to gain detailed understanding of chemical bonding in stable one-dimensional sandwich molecular wires and to understand how we can tune their desired characteristics: stability, electronic structure, magnetic properties, and electron transfer properties, and to develop recommendations for synthesis of such compounds. Time demands are estimated about 8 semesters. So this is a brief summary of the preliminary computational data which I obtained. So currently I'm studying this kind of clusters with copper, silver, and gold. And this research was inspired by these two works from 2011 and 2013. Thank you for your attention and questions.
I would like to understand what is the one-dimensional complex. What does it look like?
Okay, let's. These are examples of one-dimensional complexes, and we can just imagine them extending in this direction perpendicular to the plane of transition metal cluster and the plane of organic ligands.
You consider an axis that goes through the molecule?
Yes, exactly. Let's say this is z-direction, we could just sandwich more and more transition metal clusters and ligands in this z direction, and I am interested to see how long these wires could be.
I was thinking that these kinds of structures could already be the three-dimensional structure.
You are right. They are three-dimensional, but notification should be clarified that one-dimensional would mean that clusters could evolve only in one direction. For instance, along the z-axis perpendicular to the cluster to the cluster or ligand plane, and two-dimensional could be like elongated, for instance, in this direction, perpendicular to the plane of the screen, and three-dimensional, in these two directions, and in Z direction as well.
Is there any gender definition for complex and cluster? How can we define both of them in a very brief
way? Define what? Define what?
Cluster and complex structure. What is
cluster. So several metal atoms, for instance, connected is an example of a cluster. And complex could be like between two molecules, between polyoxymetallate and porphyrin, or between two porphyrin molecules, which I presented earlier. Okay, let's go. For instance, this is example of a complex. If we divide it, we would have two separate molecules, but the chemical identity of the parts of the complex, it would be preserved if we divide it into separate parts.
What my mind say about the complex structure is a structure where you can find different kind of geometry in one structure, whereas cluster is a big combination of complexes form a big structure. My opinion about this.
Well, it depends. You're right. We can talk about a cluster of atoms, or a cluster of molecules. Depending on what kind of building blocks we use for this cluster. Yeah, but still these kind of compounds, they are defined as complexes. And if we go, let's see. These kind of compound units they are defined as clusters. But this kind of unit, it could be defined as complex between metal cluster and between two inorganic molecules, for instance, or between metal cluster and two organic molecules. Yeah, it's indeed a question of nomenclature. When we are talking about nanoparticles, some people prefer terms nanoparticle for starting from 10 atoms, for instance, or ions, and going up to. But some people would use termin cluster or nanocluster for species small like this. So it's all the question of nomenclature, and different textbooks, different papers give you different examples.